Dame Matrix, as we predicted earlier on, it still is going to come through. As funky as this fanny bit is from Bedell, I think the problem is there's a big, there's a big lockdown on the Tota's welcome on this Barret that will be used by Blacklist International. However, the fanny is a hero that most teams against Blacklist International use to counter the Ubis strategy. Basically, their idea is, since the enemies are grouping up anyway, since Blacklist International wants to group up, Fanny might have unlimited, amount of cables to push out, energy to be exact, but nobody has ever been successful with a funny Fanny against the
That's Blacklist, man. They're testing people. They're saying, break the code. Do it. I dare you. And I love the fact that Bedell is willing to show up that fan favorite here, because the main problem right now in the meta, it's all about tempo here. And Fanny is the one thing that can push and pull that tempo with the steel cables. We'll see how they perform. Mirko, please take it away.
Will Fanny break the code? We'll see in the Land of Dawn right now as Bedell and Blacklist takes it to game number three. Let's see what happens here. Paranoid, obviously, on the Fanny pick will start on the purple buff. That will give a little bit more, prediction, easy routes for the side of Blacklist International to play with. But in the early game, what Blacklist needs to do is maybe play it a little bit safer. Again, with that Fanny, extremely, extremely good here in the early game, controlling the tempo, like Gideon says. And there you go, already pushing in. Alien jumps in very aggressively, is gonna get chunked, but Paranoid joins in all the way to the backside, still able to dash around. Right now, Blacklist just doesn't want to look for any fights, but maybe I'm wrong here, because it looks like Edward has rotated. The little Wanderer is going to be contested. Farway joins back in and goes back out. Osmo forced to flicker away as the little Wanderer will be collected by Wise, but maybe not for long here, as again, another engage happens. They are going to retreat in the end.
Oh, look at this. Bedell, even in the previous game, we saw how they were using Alien from the XP lane, then transitioning to the mid lane. What they do is to fast clear this XP lane, really deploy Alien right then and there to contest the jungle of Blacklist International. Unfortunately, Blacklist International was prepared for this. This is Rafaela to help out Wise. And Wise, as much as there's a little bit of delay when it comes to his jungling, now he's recovered. And now it's all even for Blacklist. Hell, it's even like Blacklist International leading by a little bit in the early stages of the game.
Yeah, I feel like Bedell overcommitted a little bit to that team fight. Fanny, again, they want to look for the tempo, but already some very quote-unquote weird movements here. They're trying to target that side lane. They're trying to get the most out of that gold, but not getting that orange buff will mean that Blacklist International Wise will be able to scale quite well. The turtle is going to spawn right here, presented to you by TikTok Live. Osmo trying to clear up the way, trying to set up for the turtle fight. And Blacklist, so far, they've been able to withstand this pressure very, very well.
Wise actually finds this orange buff that's not taken by Bedell, and this is massive. Look at this. Blacklist International will have a massive lead when it comes to the jungler. Not only that, they are using this Fanny. Oh my goodness, look at that burst though.
Yeah, Alien goes in for the kill. Will be able to pick it up onto Venus, and that's going to be the Razor first blood. Just huge, huge first blood for the side of Bedell. That's exactly what they need. They've been losing out on these trades. They've been giving Wise a lot of room to farm, and that is exactly what they need to come back in this game.
Not the real idea what you want to do against the... Oh, okay.
Hero has been
what slain. Is Paranoid? Going on? Paranoid going ham here. Yeah, the movements are so fast. The camera isn't able to catch it, but now it is going to be the turtle taken away by an alien.
What is happening, Bedell? I don't know who's the core anymore for Bedell.
Oh, but wait a minute. It's going to be Venus picked up for another time. Not just yet, though. Farway once again hesitates just a little bit, giving Venus some room. But Wise now trying to track down Paranoid. Will cancel in the last second, and that's going to be an amazing Abyssal Arrow to stop Wise in his tracks. But the little Wanderer once again collected. Wise is still scaling like a monster. Paranoid, though, doing a very aggressive movement here, already moving up into the lane of that top side XP lane.
I can't explain this kind of movements coming up from Paranoid. The choices are... It's not like he's playing like as a jungler. He's playing like a mid lane roamer at this point. He's given the turtle buff to the XP laner. He actually took some of the EXP from the XP laner as well. And it's also not prioritizing the jungle. This is weird, but if it works, it works. Bedell is actually trimming the deficit out to only 300 gold at this point.
Wait a minute, Bedell, they might have set up for a really good trade here. Haji gets picked up, forced to flicker away right there. Very good wall to ensure that flicker will be used. But in the mid lane, we see a skirmish going on, a duel happening between Paranoid and Wise. It will be Wise just backing away, going for the minions. and stacking it up. So far, in the fourth minute of the game, it's going to be actually Deathless Welcome used up for Edward. Trying to go for a duel right now. Alien and Edward in the 1v1. Has a turtle buff, so has a little bit more sustain, but in the end, Barracks, a true counter towards that Pikito. Still even a runaway for now, as Asmo gets beaten up quite well in the mid lane.
Let's see that. Baron is already setting up for this one. It's so weird to see like junglers take away so many lane minions in the first 5 minutes of the game. Do take note that if you have the retribution, your rewards from gold from minions, lane minions for the first 5 minutes of the game, definitely reduced. But how about that?
Red team hero has
yeah,
been
again,
slain.
He's just leaving his orange buff for Wise to take, but it turns out it might
Blue
be a bait by here as Yunxi gets killed
slain.
In the top, in the bottom side right now. Osmo goes in for some damage onto Wise. We'll be able to zone him away from the orange buff, but Blacklist International, again, they're trying to get this turret down. They are able to siege it a little bit, but in the end, it is still Bedell with the kill lead right now as of the fifth minute of the game, Gideon.
Honestly, the way that I'm looking at it, Bedell is playing a very interesting strategy, but hold your horses. Ohem might be in some trouble here.
Yeah, I'm pretty paranoid picking up a killing spree right there, and this is what they want to do with that Fanny, but I'm just surprised that Blacklist International, they haven't been able to respond to this aggression so far. They are still leading in gold, however, so if they are able to just scale up to the point where they get their power spike, it is going to be good.
Well, so far, the way that I look at it, Fanny is trying to control as much pressure on that top side, which is generally where Blacklist is supposed to be strong, is enforcing them into Clint's side. However, every single time they try to attack Clint, he doesn't need to be there. He can start farming the rest of the jungle. He's maximizing his gold everywhere he can, knowing that he won't scale for late.
Oh my goodness, man. Bedell, their answer to the code of the Blacklist International is to actually kind of be chaotic. This is like the farthest spectrum of chaotic that I have seen in competitive matches.
Red team and Bedell, has slain the turtle.
They're not getting the turtles, but at least they're getting so much gold in this map.
Oh, wait a minute. It's going to be far away going in again with the missile. Arrow is going to be able to connect. Asaji pops in the real world manipulation. Wise in a 1v1 against Paranoid right now with the help of Alien. Goes in for the knockout strike. Able to zone him away with Yushi going in. And that's going to be the kill. Wise picks up off the board. Oh, Hem is next on the chopping block. It's going to be the missile arrow not connecting just yet. Blacklist are forced to go back. And the gold lead is slowly but surely moving to the side of Bedell with the kill pressure that they have here in the early game.
Blue team hero has been slain.
Yeah, well, there you go. It's going to be another Deathless Welcome. Another fight engaged on by Edward. A lot of damage coming in for the follow-up as Ohem trying to chase him down. Asmo still able to run away, but Ohem comes in for the triple kill with that flicker. Paranoid doesn't want to leave it at that, though. He goes in for 1v3 play.
Oh,
a mistake as he gets shut down, and the Maniac has been picked up by Ohem.
What a disaster for Bedell as they went 1v1 against Blacklist International. Blacklist International duly punished them for it, and Ohem gets a 4-kill Maniac. I mean, you can't give so much of an early launch pad for this Beatrix. This is a golden Beatrix that really wants those items. Now with the Demon Hunter sword up after 4 kills, he's going to be able to take out the turret. And in a snap, Blacklist International leading by 3,000. All the things that Bedell was doing, was working for in the early stages of the game, just going out of from their hands, slipping through their hands in just a snap because of bad decisions when it comes to team fights.
Absolutely, man. But look at this. Paranoid goes in for Wise, but damage comes in, and the Deathless Welcome will be able to connect onto Osmo. Gets picked up. It's going to be Alien next to the chopping block. Gets a knockout strike, able to defend and run away for now, but not for how long. The damage comes in, the follow-up is there, and that's going to be Osmo and Alien picked up. A 2-0 right now for the side of Blacklist International, pushing themselves to a 4,000 gold lead with the third turtle spawning in that bottom side.
I can't believe that Bedell will just really crumble in this matter of seconds with Blacklist International. We're talking about how systematic Blacklist International is, and we've seen that
Red
in two
team
actions.
Has slain the turtle.
The control of the map is there. This is like the third turtle that they are able to get. For the early stages of the game, it's not looking good for Blacklist International, but just in a few minutes of the game, I mean, just a few mistakes from Bedell now, it makes it so unplayable for the Fanny. And I'm gonna have to say, Oh My Venus really reserves this holy baptism just for Paranoid in teamfights. That's a great decision. Now, there are two problems for Bedell. First is Haji and his damage output, and next is Ohem with his long-range artillery as well. We're not even counting the Aldous yet, man.
Yeah, you can see the frustration in the face of Paranoid just now as he was just chunked to half HP by the sniper. Oheb trying to clear the waves right now, able to get the siege done with the sniper. It is going to be the turret falling down.
Blue team turret trying to go for the engage,
but in the end, he's just going to zone away the members of Bedell. Blacklist still on that engage, still on that, you know, hard, basically some siege here coming in from the side of Blacklist International, but Bedell, they just have no response. They're just going to clear the waves. That's it. That's all that they can do. Blacklist, once again, invading the enemy jungle, and there's not much Bedell can do right now.
It's gonna be a difficult. Again, the jungle choke that Blacklist International did in game number one, they dominated versus Bedell this time. And goodbye to your purple buff, Fanny.
Goodbye to your purple buff indeed, man. Blacklist International going in for the purple buff. It's gonna be Paranoid jumping out to four members, baiting a lot of abilities out though. This might be the turnaround for the side of Bedell, but no, no, no. Blacklist, they play it just so calmly. They know exactly what to do, and they bait out abilities, take away the purple buff. No response. They're gonna end up taking the inhibitor, no, the tier 2 turret in the mid lane as well.
Blue team turret has been destroyed.
You say about 7 minutes to 8 minutes, it's win time for Blacklist International. They're gonna be grouping up. Maybe the only split pusher will be Wise, and that's not even counted because of the Chase Fate. He can show in team fights for sure. The Barretts will be so beefy in the front lines, going for that attack emblem as well. Both Oheb and Hatu just stand back, and oh my Venus will always
destroyed.
Just follow where Oheb is. Babysit that gold laner. Make sure that he'll not be gunned upon by the Fanny. And it's gonna be systematic and methodical from this point on.
Absolutely. Again, Edward is being such a nuisance here in the jungle, opening up the map at far away. That's an abyssal arrow connected. Alien going for engage, but that's welcome. We'll be able to connect onto Alien. He's gonna go in for the flicker. Holy Baptism connects as well. The combo is just there, and that is another kill picked up by Oheb to set up the Lord in the 10th minute here.
Gonna be very easy Lord Tick. They also spotted out where Paranoid is with the Chase Fate. And look at Edward just tanking up. Not even careful at this point.
Yeah, but look at that. Real world manipulation will be able to catch Usmo out of the... Oheb almost gets a solo kill. Flickers in for the Godlike. And he's going to go for more. Yunxi still able to get away with the second ability. But man, Blacklist from a very, very bad start. They've overcome that adversity. And now they are in with a 7,000 gold lead.
This is huge. Honestly, for Blacklist, this is huge. If they can get a steal here to slow down the game, I don't think it's going to matter too much, especially since Blacklist is so far ahead of game. But now we catch on to Wise, and things might turn around.
Yeah, things might turn around here. Wise able to dodge everything, though. What was that? It's going to be Paranoid taking off the Lord. It's going to be the Lord steal coming in. Bedell still able to withstand this fight. Oheb going in for Osmo right now as he tries to run away on the back of it all, though. It's going to be Wise jumping in. Abyssal arrow connects, and Faraway gets the pick off. A 1-0 as the Lord has been picked up by the Turkish team. Is this the turning point for Bedell?
Not yet, but that is definitely a big win for Bedell. The chain of events is just way too perfect. They were able to fend off Blacklist International, get the Lord for themselves, get a push even. And to top it all off, that Abyssal arrow to stun Wise under the turret. That's perfect.
You gotta see this one more time, guys. Honestly, I didn't expect them to actually pull this one off, but Blacklist punished them extremely well. Yunxi taking a full brunt of that damage, thinking that he was gonna die. Nope, turn it around. Even though Blacklist did lose a good number of people, this Lord push is about to turn it around.
Look at this. The turnaround happens, and the Lord will be marching down the top side. Only one lane pushing, though. Will it be enough? Ultimate's being used. Oheb will be able to clear out the minion wave, but the Abyssal Arrow will not be able to connect. Oheb now dashes forward. Real world inflation and the damage will be enough to take him down. It is going to be Bedell on the back foot as Wise joins in the team fight. Going in for Yunxi, still able to kite away for now. Alien jumps in for the peel, but will it be enough? No is the answer. The shutdown picked up as Blacklist just runs wild on Bedell. Osmo goes in for the peel once again as Alien gets away. Oheb is ready. Will he be able to snipe? He goes in and almost gets the pick off, but clean movement from Alien to get out of that situation. Though Bedell has been able to equalize in turrets.
I am lost for words. However, that's Bedell really disrespecting the defense from Blacklist International. Beatrix is one of the SSSSS tier when it comes to defense. Like, you have so much wave clear, so much high ground defense as well. You have your rocket launcher, you have your machine gun. just, Odyssey, so much defense and all it.
No, you're absolutely right there. Disrespecting, and more importantly, disrespecting the real world manipulation,
thinking that it wasn't going to lock them into place.
No, I totally get you, Wolf. But right now, Bedell has a very limited win condition. It's not going to be easy as long as Blacklist International steals away this purple buff from Paranoid.
That's right. I agree. Yep. And that's what really is their focus now.
Absolutely. Abyssal Arrow was able to connect onto Edward, but look at the backside of Hibbe. Paranoid doing some damage all the way there. Will be able to take some attention from the team, and that's actually Bedell winning in the trade. The Holy Healing comes in for the additional sustain, but Blacklist has just been pushing that bottom side now. With Wise picking it up, it is going to be not just yet, actually. The minion was not cleared up, so bottom side will still survive for now. Blacklist is trying to play the cross map with that Aldous right now.
We can see the siege from Blacklist International is going to be scary. The four-man group up, and then, of course, the Aldous is going to be there. Eve pops up the ultimate.
Yeah, Knockout Strike being used. It's going to be the Deathless Welcome connected onto Alien. He's going to go and munch him down. The wall has been placed, and that's going to be Alien taken down out of the fight instantly right here. Still able to get away with a Flicker, though, somehow. And that is another 0-for-0 trade. Blacklist weren't able to get any objectives or kills on the board for that one. And Bedell are still staying in this game in the 15-minute mark. Oh, wait a minute though. Paranoid goes in very aggressively onto the purple buff. He goes for that retribution and he actually gets it away from Blacklist. So that's a pretty good play.
Little
but now it is going to be
destroyed.
Another siege happening. Both of the teams just keep on going at it, man.
Yeah, the macro game. Look at the Blacklist International slowly like moving towards. I mean, they're catching the attention of Bedell. And the real target was for Weiss to get a split push up. And they were able to get a turret up there. And yeah, I think the Blacklist International taking this in the macro game.
Yeah, there you go. It's going to be Paranoid jumping in, trying to deal some damage as far away, and the rest of the team goes and chunks Edward really low. Ohead picks up a kill. Him because it's legendary right there. As far away will be next on the chopping block. Blacklist International, they found the way to end the game. The Lord has spawned, presented to you by TikTok Live, but will it matter? Bedell 3v5 right now in the siege against super long-range targets. Ohead on a sniper. Haji with that real-world manipulation that is going to be up just in a few seconds. It's going to be Paranoid jumping in all the way to the backside. Still dealing a lot of damage on the Haji and will be able to force him to back away for now. But Wise joins in the fight in one shot. Osmo's next and that's it. Double kill picks up for the gold laner and that's going to be Paranoid in the 1v5. Tries to run away but he gets taken down. Haji picks up the kill and the base is going to be for the Blacklist International team.
GG. Well played. I don't know, Wolf, as you mentioned, you were lost for words. That was some very, very dirty play coming in for Blacklist International. The micro definitely was on point. The adaptation definitely made the significant difference.
I think Blacklist International just showcased how good they are at the micro and the combination of those two.